So in this video, we're going to talk about the policy-based QoS and firewall rules that are available in Meru's wireless LAN system. By QoS, of course, we mean quality of service, and the way we provide quality of service is not just over the air, but also does translation of mappings towards the backend network, and I'll talk about that. So as you all are aware, Wi-Fi devices attached to a service set, or SSID, which is really the name of the service that you typically type when your Windows 0 config pops up. And that allows you to connect to the wireless abstraction of a VLAN or a subnet. So devices, wireless devices associate with the network by means of connecting to a service ID or SSID. Now, each SSID has its own security policies. So at the layer two, you might do WAP or CLEAR or WPA or WPA2, which are some of the standard security policies per the 802.11 standard. Now, the way we map SSIDs to essentially differentiate users is the following. So first off, associated with an SSID, we have something called an ESS profile. Now, this is a profile wherein multiple profiles might have the same SSID, and we'll talk about why that's relevant. For each ESS profile, you can map it to a VLAN, a virtual LAN. You can also assign something called a filter ID, which is essentially a policy tag that we associate with every device that connects to a profile. And you can map SSIDs or an ESS profile to some number of access points. So this is a list of access points. Okay. So the purpose of or the relevance of these fields is going to become apparent in a few minutes. So let's assume that you have a certain area, right? And this area is, let us say, being served by four access points. Let us call this AP1, AP2, AP3, and AP4. In this coverage area, you might have certain locations where you want to restrict access. So for example, let us say a guest SSID is only available in the lobby area. So you provide a guest. And as for employees, that service is available in all of the access points, except that in certain locations, you might want to ascribe different security or quality of service policies. We'll talk about the different usage cases once we sort of go over the technology. So you might have a guest SSID and an employee SSID, right? And notice that is the same employee SSID that is advertised whether you're in this location or this location. It's just that you get mapped to different service profiles, or you get mapped to sort of different back-end quality of service and firewall profiles. So in this particular case, let's call this guest. The advertised SSID is guest. VLAN is V1, some tag. Filter ID is G. And in this particular case, the APs are AP1. And now you'll call this EMP1. SSID is employee. V2, call this E1, call this AP2 and AP3. And then you have a third one where you have a different ESS profile, but the same advertised SSID, right? Call this V3, and you say E2, and this goes on AP4. So just to step back and see what we've created a wireless LAN where you have two advertised SSIDs. Devices might associate with one or the other. If you're a guest, that service is only available on AP1. If you go further down in the system, you will not be able to connect to the wireless network because there is no service available. If you're an employee, you'll be able to connect pretty much everywhere. I'm sorry, this should also be AP1 here, right? If you're an employee, you'll be able to connect to the SSID anywhere in the region, except that if you connect in the region of AP1, 2, or 3, you get tagged according to the employee one service ESS profile, which gives you a filter ID of E1. If you connect in this region, AP4, you'll get tagged with E2. So when a user comes in, the user gets this particular filter ID tag, call it a policy tag, that is based on what is specified by the profile. not the advertised SSID. That's the first point. In addition, corresponding to each of these profiles, you have the ability to define how this filter ID gets applied. So it could be either based on, you know, these values, or you could have a tag that says, is it radius defined or not? And radius, of course, being a policy engine on the back. So depending upon the particular service, you could say radius defined yes and no here. Wherein what happens is the following. As a particular user comes into this location, the user associates with the network. At that point, the wireless LAN infrastructure goes and checks with the radius server to see whether this particular user is going to be assigned a specific tag or not. If not, then it'll default back to E2. Otherwise, a user can get a customized tag. So let's step back and see what we've done so far. You have the ability to assign users to multiple profiles, even though they share the same SSID. These profiles are location specific. A user gets a particular policy tag based on either the ESS profile, in other words, a combination of the SSID and location, or it can be overridden based on the backend policy engine, the radius engine. Now, once the user comes into the network, we kind of forget about this from the perspective of, you know, layer 3 and layer 4, and what we are going to work with is this filter ID that has been assigned on a per user basis, either on the basis of their profile or based on what a backend policy engine, you know, mandates, right? So let's keep it at that and now move on to the next level of trying to differentiate services and differentiate the way packets are transmitted or treated based on policies. And there are sort of five basic classes of policies. One is user-based. The second is location-based. The third is subnet-based, based on the IP addresses of the source and or destination. The fourth one is service or SSID-based, and the last one is application-based. So now what I'm going to describe is how we use a combination of the user IP address or the source and destination IP address based on the sort of access of the user as well as the filter ID of the user, right? So notice that the way we assign filter ID, we can already do it user-based, location-based, and SSID-based. We just talked about how you can ascribe these policy IDs based on a combination of these three.